Only one cigarette, Chesterfield, gives you mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste. And that's the biggest plus in cigarette history.
By Chesterfield, the one that proves its case. Yes, Chesterfields are milder, plus no aftertaste.
So home, open the pack and give them a sniff.
Then you'll smoke them.
Someone waits for me.
This is Ken Carpenter. Welcome you to the Bing Crosby Show for Chesterfield. Produced and transcribed in Hollywood with John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, Jed Collins of the Bears, and Bing's guests, Tommy Dorsey, Joe Venuti, and Miss Theresa Brewer. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we bring you a prominent resident of Hollywood, California, who visits here occasionally, Bing Crosby.
Hey, Ken. I must tell you, Ken, that you're really kidding on the square because you know I got to spend more time in Hollywood. Yeah. I realized that only recently because I nearly missed the broadcast today. I was mistaken for a tourist.
Tourist?
Yep.
What happened?
Well, I was walking down Vine Street looking for a snooker game. All of a sudden, a long, strong arm reached out from a sightseeing bus and yanked me aboard.
And off you went into the wild blue yonder.
Yep,
huh?
Before I knew it, I'd visited Grauman's Chinese Theater, the Farmer's Market, the La Brea Tar Pits, Knott's Berry Farm, the movie stars' homes, and the San Marino Preserving Kitchen. And Strip's Cafe.
Quite a trip.
Well, sure was. And tonight.
Tonight?
Tonight, I'm going for the full tour. We're going to Chinatown, the Planetarium, the Bubble Dance in Gardena, Peter Potter's television show, and the Lincoln Heights Jail.
You're winding up the Lincoln Heights Jail.
Well, there's a pickpocket working the bus, and we're dropping him off there.
I hope you all get your wallets back.
I got two back already.
You're doing well.
But, Ken, sightseeing here around Los Angeles, it's wonderful. There's no question. There's a lot of things to see. It's very, very fine, but it's nothing like the trip I just had driving through Nevada, Wyoming, Montana, Idaho, Oregon.
Been covering all that territory the way you did and just staying a night or so at every stop. Must have reminded you of the old days when you're doing one-nighters with the Paul Whiteman band, didn't it?
Yeah, it did, Ken. It did remind me of the days when I traveled with Whiteman. Of course, this was a much healthier trip. And on this trip, I remember every town I visited. Elko, Nevada, Jackson Hole, Wyoming, Ennis, Montana, Big Sport, Montana.
Okay. We'll take your word for it.
Yes, please, yes.
Anyhow, being with Tommy Dorsey and Joe Venuti as your guests tonight, this program marks quite an auspicious reunion of the Paul Whiteman Alumni Association.
There's very few of us left, you know.
You know, these are certainly great days for Dorsey fans in this area.
Yes, the Dorsey fans. Come on.
Tommy and his band down at Casino Gardens in Ocean Park. Jimmy and his orchestra at the Palladium here in Hollywood.
Well, this is earthquake country. We can take it.
Gosh, are Tommy and Jimmy still fighting with each other?
Oh, no, I didn't mean to convey that. No, they've made up. They're all fine.
Mm-hmm.
Buddies, yeah. They've settled all their differences amicably. A complete truce has been effected.
Well, what do you know? Was Dean Acheson instrumental in bringing them together?
No, it required real diplomacy to handle this case. And now approaching, ladies and gentlemen, is another case that may require a little diplomacy. Ladies and gentlemen, the world's greatest jazz violinist, Signor Giuseppe Venuti.
Is this the place?
Yeah, this is the place. Say, Joe, I want to congratulate you on something here. I heard your recording of Hot Canary. Wonderful disc, Joe. A big tune, of course, and I hear those disc jockeys just playing your record all the time.
You ought to drop by and see my canary bird sometime.
You got a canary?
Yeah, and what an appetite he's got.
Appetite? How much can a canary eat? All you have to do is give him a little French's bird seed.
No bird seed for my canary.
What does he eat?
He eats what I eat. Ravioli, meatballs, pasta, fasula, lasagna.
Get out. You feed your canary all that heavy food, all those starches?
Sure.
Golly, how much does it weigh?
97 pounds in his bare feet.
In his bare feet? 97 pounds.
Hey, Bing, my canary is bigger than the average emu.
Emu, 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 nuki, nuki, maki.
Oh, yaku.
Joe, how about you and I doing a little number for the folks? I got a record out now on a new tune, a thing called Shanghai, you know it?
I can't play Shanghai. I didn't bring my Chinese fiddle.
Oh, lovers of Chinese music are going to be desolate.
Well, we'll do it another time then, Joe. We'll both wear our coolie coats, huh?
And spats.
Yes. Shanghai is dedicated to Mr. Tommy Lyman, the great authority on Shanghai, who is now singing at the William Tell restaurant in New York City.
I must go in there some night and get the apple shot off my dome.
I'll be your guest, Joe. John, let's play this thing, huh? For Shanghai. Did I say I was going to Shanghai?
Oh, man, I must have been out of my American mind.
Did I tell you I was going to Shanghai? I want to be with you tonight. Why did I holler I was going to Shanghai? I want to be with you tonight. This was just a little misunderstanding, but a kiss on the cheek could patch. I need you so badly, I'd gladly start all over from scratch. Oh, why did I tell you it was bye-bye to Shanghai? I'm even allergic to rice.
Now, why don't you stop me when I talk about Shanghai?
It's just a lover's advice. Who's gonna kiss me? Who's gonna thrill me? Who's gonna hold me tight? I'm right around the corner in a phone booth, and I wanna be with you tonight.
Telegram here that really gives you the lowdown on cigarette advertising. It's a telegram that was sent to the makers of Chesterfield. And here's what it says, and I quote, "A panel of five, all members of the faculty of the College of Liberal Arts of the University of New Hampshire, has just completed for our foundation a survey and appraisal of cigarette advertising. The advertising copy of five leading cigarettes was subjected to scrutiny and study. You'll be pleased to know that only Chesterfield advertising was judged entirely free from misleading statements or false claims. This is the unanimous opinion of the panel. The honesty of your advertising is indicative of the honesty of your product. Signed, W. Keith Simpson, Director of the Newington Foundation." Well, Ken, seems to me that telegram sort of speaks for itself.
Right, Bing. It proves that the Chesterfield folks tell only the straight facts, the truth. Folks, when we say Chesterfield gives you mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste, you can believe it.
When we say Chesterfield is the best cigarette for you to smoke, you can believe that, too. Smoke them, and you'll see what I mean. Always buy Chesterfield. Now, ladies and gentlemen, may I present a vivacious, diminutive, talented, brilliant young vocalist, Miss Theresa Brewer. How about those snappy black eyes? And they really sparkle. Theresa, how are you feeling? You ready? You going to sing something for us?
Oh, yes. Do you know the Wang Wang Blues?
Do I know the Wang Wang Blues?
You mean if you ever see him come and shake his shoes because the Wang Wang Blues is awful hard to lose, is there the one?
Those are the ones.
Oh, I've had them many times. Yes, sir. Theresa, I think you should sing this song in the interest of public service. Those Wang Wang Blues are something fierce. Everybody should be warned to get them. Pound the tocsin for all to hear right in yonder there now, Theresa.
Thank you, Teresa. Thank you very much. Now, folks, I'd like to present one of our very great orchestra leaders, a man who hit the tops in the music business and who stayed there for, lo, these many years. Folks, that sentimental gentleman, Tommy Dorsey.
Thank you, James.
Tommy, that's really great having you with us here on the show.
It's nice to be here, Bing.
Gosh, Tom, with you and Joe Venuti here tonight, I can't help but recall the days, the good old days, you know, when we were with Paul Whiteman. Weren't we the cut-ups? Boy, you used to drive him out of his mind.
Oh, you're a little wrong there, Bing.
What do you mean?
Oh, you and Joe Venuti gave the old man a bad time. But me, I was very shy and retiring in those days.
What? What do you mean?
I always came to rehearsal on time. I never drew any money in advance. And I never missed a show.
You were a model prisoner, weren't you?
Whiteman adored me, Bing. He even let me carry his chyron.
He did. Now, you know, I carried his caviar in an empty sword cane. But you and he were real buddy-buddy pals, huh?
Of course, I did bend my horn around his neck a couple of times.
Well, of course, under great stress.
I never could stand bandleaders anyway until I became one.
Say, you know when that was? We were working white. I was just thinking the other day. That was back in 1929.
Mm-hmm.
Stock market crashed that year. And they had prohibition, too.
Ah, those were the good old days.
Yes,
the happy days.
Do you remember Plunkett's rental library? Remember that little rental library in New York where we used to hang out between shows?
Yeah, Bing, we used to read so much in there, we used to walk out practically blind.
Well, it was such a wonderful little library covered with ivy and the elevator wrapped around it.
Oh, yes, oh, I can see it now.
Had the best free lunch in town. I still owe Plunkett for a couple of books.
I owe him for the Encyclopedia Britannica.
Ah, we were wild then, Tommy, but we certainly soaked up a lot of knowledge, didn't we?
Bing, as I recall, my favorite book was by Johnny Walker.
Oh, Grand Rider. Grand Rider. Yes, he was.
Had a black label.
But he had another bestseller out with a red label. Went very big.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, I tell you, Bing, bookstores ain't what they used to be.
Oh. Now they're just bookstores. It's fun, though, reminiscing in the town. And may I congratulate you? I think congratulations are in order because you have some fine records out now under the Deodeca label.
Well, may I return the compliment?
Please do. Yes. You know the big favorite around our house, Tommy? Diane.
Oh, good.
Yeah. How about limbering up the old trombone, giving us that now, huh?
Well, Diane has a nice vocal in it, Bing. How about you latching on to that?
The vocal? Fine. Sure. Well, where do I come in?
I'll nudge you with the trombone.
Well, careful, or I may open with a very high note. But go ahead. Apologies to Jack Leonard for the vocal. Now, at this point, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to bring back a very talented violinist who was heard from earlier in the show here. The only person I know who owns a 97-pound canary that eats ravioli. Giuseppe Venuti. Say, Joe, does your canary bird really weigh 97 pounds? Hmm?
Sure. He swallows cats, and we're going to have him for Thanksgiving.
Well, it's about time the canaries got even, I guess. Let's have hot canary, Joe.
How's it going, Joe?
Fine. Really in there. Now, if T. Dorsey will sort of slide back here with his trombone, maybe the three of us can take off on some tune.
Well, do you think Lady Be Good would do it?
Yeah, Lady Be Good, that might be fine. I'll start it, huh? You still here, Joe?
Is this the place?
This is the place. Let's go.
Okay.
This is the place where there's the people.
Oh, sweet and lovely Lady Be Good. Oh, Lady Be Good to me. I am so awfully misunderstood. Oh, Lady Be Good to me. I'm all alone in this big city. I tell you, I'm just a lonesome babe in the woods. Oh, Lady Be Good to me.
Did you know tomorrow is the first day of summer?
Oh, I hate to see it come, Ken. You know, after next week's show, we'll all be unemployed until fall.
Oh, why, you'll make out all right.
Well, here and there, fish a little, you know. Better play it safe, though. I think I'll put in for my unemployment compensation like... Well, Hope does, you know.
Oh, I can't believe Bob does that.
Oh, he certainly does. He's drawing his old age pension, too. But getting back to the first day of summer, Ken, it seems to me vacation time is starting. I'll bet a lot of folks are packing their bags right now, and I want to make sure they pack along plenty of milder Chesterfield. Folks, vacation time, anytime. Chesterfield's the best cigarette for you to smoke. First, Chesterfield gives you its famous ABCs.
Always milder, better tasting, cooler smoking.
And Chesterfield gives you all that plus the added pleasure of no unpleasant aftertaste, and that's the biggest plus in cigarette history.
Science discovered it. You can prove it. science discovered that of all brands tested, only Chesterfield leaves no unpleasant aftertaste. And you can prove it by smoking Chesterfield. They taste better, and after you smoke them, no unpleasant aftertaste.
Latch onto a pack or make it a carton, and you'll see what we mean. The best cigarette for you to smoke is Chesterfield.
Buy Chesterfield, Chesterfield, the one that proves its taste. Yes, Chesterfield's a milder, milder, plus no aftertaste.
Go home, open the pack, and give them a sniff.
Then you'll smoke them.
Paramount just finished a picture called Here Comes the Groom, in which I'm more or less involved. This is one of the ballads from the piece. Bon week, good night, just dream away the dawn. That's our closer. My thanks to Theresa Brewer, Joe Venuti, and Tommy Dorsey for being here.
I enjoyed it very much, Bing. And do you mind if I announce that I appeared through the courtesy of the beautiful Casino Gardens at Ocean Park, where my orchestra plays nightly except Monday?
Oh. I may come down there and win a cup some night doing the rumba. Say, Joe, where's your band playing now?
Oh, we open where the surf meets the turf.
Where's this?
The Del Mar.
Del Mar. In August or June. Well, the racing will be on. See, Del Mar's a beautiful spot, Joe. You can have a lot of fun down there. Besides, you can pick up some money.
You can drop some, too.
Well, it's only money. It has no personality. Easy come, easy drop. Folks, before I say goodnight, I want to remind you vacation time is starting, and you can't go wrong if you follow Dr. Crosby's formula for a fine vacation. First, have a real good time.
Eat a lot of good food.
Get lots of sunshine.
And plenty of shut-eye.
And to complete the formula, take along plenty of milder Chesterfields. The best way to pack them is to pack them by the carton. So just slip a couple of cartons in there between the socks and the handkerchief. Remember, vacation time, anytime, Chesterfield's the one for you.
Crosby Show, presented by Chesterfield, was produced and transcribed in Hollywood by Bill Morrow and Murdo MacKenzie. Tune in next week and hear Bing and his guests, Burl Ives, Laurie Anders, and Ken Murray.